I wipe myself so hard, I bleed every day.
Actually, I've been bleeding a lot too lately. I think the air is just dry. I'm drying.
It's dry. You guys need to get a bidet.
I got a squatty potty. At least threw it out.
Is that the one we won in the crane game?
No, that one got stolen.
Well, that was in the men's
Hello
restroom,
Kitty
right?
Squatty potty that I was like, oh, good, we'll have one for work. Yeah, it was there. It was in our bathroom for 2 days, and then someone took it.
Everyone looks at James and thinks he has the perfect life, but
no,
he suffers like
the worst
of us.
Life.
All right, guys, I got a little exercise. You ready?
Yeah.
I'll start. And we're all going to complete the sentence that I say. Oh, it's not a joke spot.
You couldn't even finish the sentence you started.
It's not an on-the-spot joke. This is just a normal thing.
Okay.
Well, that's a contradiction in terms,
But first, do the double finger.
No!
Sorry, go ahead.
Here I go. All right, ready? This will be the intro to the video. Okay. Ready? Grand.
Torino.
It's not Grand Torino. It's Grand Torino. First of all.
Oh, I forgot, because he's a grandpa.
Yeah. All right, I'll start again. We'll start again. Ready? Right. Grand.
Wizard.
Fucking shit.
What?
Adam. We're going to Adam.
Sure.
Grand.
Theft.
Auto.
Is?
Five.
He's supposed to say five. That's supposed to be the intro to the video.
Technically, we've been playing online.
Yeah.
It's not really GTA 5.
All right. Grand.
Theft.
Auto.
Five.
You son of a bitch. You're supposed to say online.
Yeah, we just discussed it, Lawrence.
I wasn't listening.
Hey, what are we playing today, Adam? We're playing Bomb Ball 3.
What are we doing this, Adam?
I have no idea.
Oh, you gotta, okay.
You gotta put it in the goal?
Up
that's
there.
Not how that works. You gotta push it into the target, and then it explodes, I guess.
Oh, right there.
There you, you got it.
Yeah,
that's it. Bang.
James wins.
Oh, it's Rocket League.
Scored.
How dare you, Percy?
Goodbye, friend.
But actually, that was your teammate.
Yeah, I know.
Ah!
Press right on the D-pad to use the gun tower.
Oh.
That's cool.
What?
Oh, Adam did what I always do, which is see things.
Oh, that's cool.
Fire him, yeah. Huh? Fire.
Isn't he on your team? Your vehicle is about to blow up, though.
Oh.
You won.
Yay.
Game over.
Wait, purple team won.
Do you like it? So does it matter which ball goes into which hole?
Yeah,
it looks like it gives you points.
I would guess
like
they're different amounts of things. Points.
Yeah. Oh.
You think the purple one's worth more?
No. I mean, like, that one has a bomb on it. Others have skulls.
Well, why are you going around the backside, though?
I don't really have much of a choice.
So does it matter which pole?
Yeah, everyone looks at James and thinks he has the perfect butt.
Well, why are you going around the backside, though?
I don't really have much of a choice.
I'll start. This is just a normal thing.
But first, do the double finger.
He's shooting you. You're going to die. Fuck that guy on a motorcycle, are you joking? He's gonna kill you.
How did he kill me? That's like losing a fight to Chucky.
Right. I just right into it, okay.
Did you know you can't buy those, like, compressed air bullhorns over the internet?
Why?
Oh, because they can't ship them through the mail, yeah, probably?
Over the top!
Good movie.
Yeah! Nice! Oh, you're trying to flamethrow you.
Hey, it's like, Fury Road!
Right in there!
Oh!
Alright, there you go, that's on. Right there.
That counts for me!
That was for you. That was definitely for you.
That counts for me too. Stop shooting me!
He's gonna kill you, yeah.
For no reason. Yeah!
Nice job. Whoa! Yeah. First place?
Yeah.
I'm never playing this again. I got first place, first try.
Alright, first place.
In.
I'm not wearing my glasses.
Take me out, coach. That's what all star players say.
Yeah, I did really good.
Hey!
Take me out.
I scored. Take me out, coach. I was on a basketball team.
Yeah.
Like a kid's basketball team.
Yeah.
I remember I got fouled, so I got to take some free throws. I hit them both.
Nice.
And then the next game, I like gestured to my coach, like, if you need anyone to nail some free throws or whatever, like, use me. And he's like, okay, cool. And at the time, I didn't realize that he probably thought I was an asshole.
Why?
Because I had scored 2 points the whole season.
Right. Yeah,
and it was because no one was allowed to touch me.
That was the whole season. Oh, wow.
No one was allowed to touch me.
That's different.
You're great when you're not under pressure.
Yeah, I know. I was like, coach, you need someone. I remember gesturing like this. And he was like,
whatever.
I mean, in my defense, the scoring of these games was probably like 12-8 or something because they were all just kids.
I remember going to some cousin or someone's like basketball game, but it was like real young, like 5 or something. Not a score the entire game.
Awesome. That's tough.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Hoops are so high.
Did they say they were both winners at the end? Because I hate that shit.
They're both losers.
They're both losers.
They're going to be one winner, but they're going to be infinite losers.
Every time it'd go up and the coach started out real strong. Like, get out there, Tim. You're going to do it. Just by the end, he's on his phone.
Do they still have those leagues where even it doesn't matter, they don't keep score or some shit?
That's stupid.
I hope not.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Kids need to get used to losing early.
Look, you can let anybody play as far as I'm concerned, but there have to be scores and there has to be a winner. Someone has to lose over and over like I did in flag football.
What?
Because otherwise you don't learn the value of losing.
That's true. No, you're absolutely right.
You got to learn the value of losing.
Let's see, I lost in basketball, football, karate, tennis, chess club.
Do you guys ever lose and then just publicly start crying? And then get so embarrassed that you cried even harder?
I cried in the car ride on the way home.
It was one time I got second place in a spelling bee and I broke my medal. I was so upset.
That sounds like Bruce.
I remember I waited by the mailbox for 3 weeks waiting for my karate gi to come.
Uh-huh.
Because I got the cool black one.
Oh, that's really cool.
And then I got it. I finally got it and it looked awesome. And I lost immediately when
Wait, you were in a karate tournament?
Well, yeah, you pay $20. Yeah. They'll let you enter anything.
Yeah.
Wait, did you have any training in
karate? Well, first of all, I was a yellow belt.
Oh, that's cool.
Was it actually karate or taekwondo?
It was karate.
I did taekwondo as a kid.
I did taekwondo.
It was true taekwondo, because I remember using my hands a lot. But I do remember there was one point where I was supposed to spar with my instructor, and he was like, okay, you know, all right, we're sparring, whatever. And I went,
so you can...
I tried to hit him with Shoryuken.
Nice.
And?
It was close.
You missed.
He stumbled.
All right, you missed. Sounds like you missed.
And then he was like, whoa! Like, and I was like... I remember coming in the next day going...
yeah, and he went. I had a Taekwondo instructor. He's like, okay, let's spar. I was in college. And he's like, we were sparring, and he knew I was like trying to take it serious and do well. And I hit him with like not a very good, it was like a nice little jab or something or a kick. He got upset because I did it in front of class. And so he axe kicked me on top of my head those little helmets that you wear for sparring. Yeah. He hooked his leg into my, and then he dragged me down with it.
Awesome.
He humiliated me in front of the class.
Dude, martial arts instructors have the most fragile egos. I love it.
That said, he did teach Taekwondo to me for free. So I appreciate that. It was very nice of him.
I don't know if that was an instructor.
Yeah, I mean, did he also have a van? The only price he paid was that he got to humiliate you and beat you up.
Yeah.
Teaching is a very loose
thing. You got busted.
Fuck!
We should all sign up for fucking martial arts class
and
make Rooster Teeth pay for it.
James, I would love that dearly.
There's a Capoeira studio not too far from here.
I've taken Capoeira. You don't want to. Those are weirdos. They go to Whole Foods a lot.
Can we just do like a Zumba class?
No! Zumba is not a martial art, despite what they tell you.
That's right, we won!
Oh, look at us!
Hey, you're all losers!
Wait, that's us, though.
No, not them. The other ones. Okay. I have to humiliate them, just like I got humiliated by my Taekwondo instructor.
Did you know that Capoeira is, they fight like this because their hands were chained?
Slave fighting.
Did you know that? Yep.
Really?
Oh. Yeah, it looked like dancing. The slaves had to make it look like they were dancing, but they were actually training themselves.
We all know that Krav Maga is the most superior martial art. And the reason is because you can take on seven people at once. That's why. Sorry. That's the Batman martial art, and it wins. So.
No, Bruce. Let me tell you about Salat. It's huge Russian dude just going poof.
Hold on.
Real hard.
There's also Savat, where you stand like a dandy and you only kick at other people's shins.
Have you guys seen the slap technique?
No.
Oh, there's a dude who just makes his arm limp and he just rolls around just doing this all the time. There he goes.
Whoa!
Oh, he's coming for you. Wait for it. The sound of them fighting each other is the best because it's just like meat slaps.
He's got nunchucks.
Is this on Vine?
He's coming at you.
Oh, he's simulating the use of a weapon with his hands.
Yeah. Whoa! Who won?
Wait for it. And here!
What? That's pretty fast.
Holy cow, that's a lot of strikes.
It's an impressive sound.
but they all only feel like a mouse hits you?
Yeah.
Why is he shirtless?
Because he's working hard.
It's just, see, you guys are used to all the fancy stuff. This is about winning fights. This is about winning fights as quickly as possible. I like that move.
What's he doing? Is he using his elbow?
He throws himself purposefully off balance, then uses his falling momentum to strike.
Oh, this isn't good.
Ow.
Ooh, that hurt.
Yeah.
That hurt. He got hurt there. He got hurt there.
What are you hitting here? You're hitting the most defended part of a person.
Yeah.
Their shins and like hips.
Oh, you're right.
Those aren't soft targets and it's gonna hurt like a motherfucker.
Ooh, that piece of paper!
Oh.
I like it.
Get a
load. He didn't break that one.
Now imagine that piece of paper was your nose.
Oh, he did break it. Look,
it would sting real bad. You'd be like, ah!
That's you split under your eye or something.
No, your skin's not like paper.
Wait, what? Why are they on a greasy floor?
That's his house.
Yeah, this is Russia.
One, two.
They were doing this all day. It's nighttime now. You notice that?
Yeah.
Let's go back to GTA. Yeah, what were you doing?
Oh, nice job, Lawrence.
Parkour.
You're actually first.
Guys, dedicate to the jump. A little life advice from the parkour crew. You got to dedicate to that jump. You might be scared, but
your fear is only going to make you miss the jump.
You got to tell yourself, I'm going to do it no matter what.
Me?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, I bet that. I think I can. No, I even got it. I can
switch under there.
Oh, how about that feel?